Some of you may have heard of Rupert Sheldrake, the pseudoscientist whom some folks see as credible because he has sometimes done real science. He did a TED talk some time ago that TED took down because it was asinine. In it, he outlines what he believes to be 10 dogmas of science. He thinks there are views which are held by the scientific community unquestioningly, and this is keeping alternative views from getting a fair hearing. So here are the first of these supposed dogmas. First, that nature is mechanical, or machine-like. The universe is like a machine. Animals and plants are like machines. We're like machines. In fact, we are machines. We are lumbering robots, in Richard Dawkins' vivid phrase, with brains that are genetically programmed computers. Second, matter is unconscious. The whole universe is made up of unconscious matter. There's no consciousness in stars, galaxies, in planets, in animals, in plants, and there ought not to be any in us either if this theory's true. So a lot of the philosophy of mind over the last 100 years has been trying to prove that we're not really conscious at all. Complete straw man. The reason materialists say that matter is not conscious is because when you say something is conscious, you are talking about what something does, not what something is. Matter is not inherently conscious, but when matter forms into a brain, it can undertake the activity of consciousness. Scientists do not reject other views because they are dogmatically opposed to them. They reject other views because they either can't make testable predictions, or when they do, those predictions have been falsified. The laws of nature are fixed. This is dogma 3. The laws of nature are the same now as they were at the time of the Big Bang, and they'll be the same forever. Laws, by definition, are fixed. This is not a dogma, it's the definition of the word law. Now you may say that scientists don't have a strong basis on which to assume that any particular principle that we deem to be a law is fixed, and that maybe these things can change, but that wouldn't mean that laws aren't fixed. It would mean, if it were the case, that laws don't really exist. Dogma 4. The total amount of matter and energy is always the same. It never changes in total quantity except at the moment of the Big Bang when it all sprang into existence from nowhere in a single instant. Another straw man. Matter and energy didn't spring into existence from nowhere. Maybe it came from some other universe in the multiverse, or maybe the Big Bang is just a temporal boundary rather than an event in which matter and energy began to exist. Saying that the universe sprang into existence assumes that a universe which is temporally finite in the past is therefore physically contingent. Matter and energy didn't spring into existence, because at no time has matter and energy been separate from existence. See my other video on this topic, I'll put a link in the description. Also, scientists don't believe in the law of conservation of matter and energy dogmatically. They believe it because no exception has ever been found. If an exception were ever confirmed, they would stop calling it a law. The fifth dogma is that nature is purposeless. There are no purposes in all nature, and the evolutionary process has no purpose or direction. To say that the universe has a purpose is to assume that there is a god or some other conscious entity which has some purpose in mind. Science rejects this idea not because it is dogmatically committed to the assumption that it is false, but rather because it has no practical meaning. It makes no testable predictions. There would be no way of testing and disproving the assertion that something has some kind of mysterious unknown purpose. No matter what test you ran, you could always say that there is still some purpose that we just haven't found yet. It's completely unfalsifiable. Dogma 6. Biological heredity is material. Everything you inherit is in your genes or in epigenetic modifications of your genes or in cytoplasmic inheritance. It's material. Well, how the fuck would you inherit something that isn't material? What the fuck does that even mean? If inheritance is not in your genes, then where the fuck else would it be? Sheldrake believes in something called morphic resonance, which is the idea that memory is inherent to nature. Presumably, the molecules in your body don't just carry physical genes, but also non-physical memory, whatever that's supposed to mean. I think Sheldrake gets this idea from the New Agey types who assert that water has memory, which is why they say homeopathic medicine is more effective the more diluted it is, because the water used to dilute it remembers the medicinal ingredients that were in it, and presumably, for some reason, forgets all of the poisons. But how is this memory stored? And more importantly, how is it retrieved? I have no idea how such a thing would even work. Now, I know some of the digital physics folks would say that all matter is essentially information, but this is not what Sheldrake is saying. Sheldrake believes that in addition to the physical properties that matter has, which could arguably be reduced to information, natural systems such as termite colonies or pigeons or orchid plants or insulin molecules inherit a collective memory from all previous things of their kind. I have no idea how this would work, and it certainly hasn't been demonstrated to be the case. Dogma 7. Memories are stored inside your brain as material traces. Somehow, everything you remember is in your brain in modified nerve endings, phosphorylated proteins. Again, this is not a dogma. It is inferred from the evidence. Every mind we've ever encountered has been accompanied by a brain. The moment scientists encounter a mind that exists independently of a brain, they will accept that the two can be separated. Until then, it is perfectly reasonable to suppose that no such thing exists. Dogma 8. Your mind is inside your head. All your consciousness is the activity of your brain and nothing more. If you have a different testable hypothesis, present it and scientists will test it, and they will test it with the same objectivity and rigor that they test any other hypothesis. In fact, some of Sheldrake's hypotheses actually have been tested, like when he said that dogs were psychic, and surprise, his assertion was not supported by the evidence. Dogma 9, which follows from Dogma 8, psychic phenomena like telepathy are impossible. Your thoughts and intentions cannot have any effect at a distance because your mind's inside your head. Therefore, all the apparent evidence for telepathy and other psychic phenomena is illusory. Scientists do not believe that they are impossible. Claims about psychic phenomena have been tested many, many times. If scientists just assumed that they were impossible, they never would have bothered testing them in the first place. Scientists reject claims of psychic phenomena not because of dogma, but because there have been a bajillion experiments testing psychic abilities, and they have never been shown to work. People believe these things happen, but it's just because they don't know enough about statistics, or they're deceived by coincidences, or it's wishful thinking. That's not why scientists think that the apparent evidence for telepathy is illusory. The reason they think it is illusory is that a lot of the evidence is anecdotal, and even when it does come from a lab, the experiments have been shown to be flawed, and the results have rarely, if ever, been successfully repeated. Sheldrake seems to think that making rational inferences based on the evidence and the quality of the evidence is dogma. And Dogma 10, mechanistic medicine is the only kind that really works. That's why governments only fund research into mechanistic medicine and ignore complementary and alternative therapies. Those can't possibly really work because they're not mechanistic. Again, it's not a dogma when you base a belief on mountains of fucking evidence. Scientists do not believe that mechanistic medicine is necessarily the only kind that works. It is simply the only kind that has ever been shown to work. And this is not due to lack of investigation. Lots of tests have been done on lots of alternative forms of medicine, and they have failed those tests again and again and again. And the reason governments only fund mechanistic medicine is not due to a dogmatic presupposition of materialism. The US government has funded research into reported non-materialist phenomena like remote viewing with the $20 million Stargate project and found no convincing results. I suspect the reason they don't fund non-mechanistic medicine is because they don't want to waste another $20 million rather than because they harbor some materialistic dogma.